of the Human Rights Initiative, which is a program that we launched in June of this year. I rejoined CSIS after having been at USAID in the Obama administration for 4 years, leading work on democracy, human rights, and governance with our good friends from IRI and the NED and other organizations. First, let me introduce the head of IRI, who's going to make the introduction of our very, very special guest, Ruslana. Michael Green. Mark Green became president in January 2014, and last night hosted a fabulous event with Senator McCain and others to celebrate all the good work that IRI does around the world. Why don't you take it over?
Great. Well, thank you. Thanks, Sarah. Thanks to CSIS for hosting us here today. I am very pleased to be able to welcome Ruslana here today. As Sarah mentioned, last night IRI did its annual Freedom Dinner. We handed out two of our very highest awards, our Freedom Award. One was to President George H.W. Bush, and the second one was to the men and women of the Maidan. So why? Why would we celebrate the Maidan movement? Why would we have it as our highest awardee? Well, as
someone who visited the Maidan twice in recent months, my brief experience there was one of the most moving things that I have ever seen. To walk through the Maidan, to go to those lampposts that were filled with bullet holes, where democracy activists tried in vain to hide from the bullets of the thugs who fired from rooftops. To take a look at what the democracy activists were using to try to protect themselves, to stand up for democracy and liberty and human rights in the face of the forces led by or inspired by Vladimir Putin was astounding and moving in so many ways. But you didn't have to visit the Maidan to be inspired, of course. We all sat glued to our televisions during those days and weeks and months, and we saw people coming together from all walks of life, from all backgrounds, simply standing up for the cause of liberty and asking for the right to choose their own future. And that's why IRI believed that the men and women of the Maidan were deserving of our very highest honor. As we were pointing towards last night, we tried to think of who might best give voice to those courageous activists. Well, one person quickly came to mind, Ruslana, the courageous woman who is with us here today, who is seen by so many as the very face of the Euromaidan movement. For more than 100 days and nights, she stood, performed, and motivated crowds on the Maidan. One reason that she commands so much respect in her country is that she is not a newcomer to the cause. She was an active participant in the 2004 Orange Revolution. She served as an MP for the Our Ukraine Party in 2006 and 2007. Even to this day, she remains true to the spirit of the Maidan by leading civic efforts to support refugees from Crimea and the Donbas. She also performs routinely for Ukrainian troops in eastern Ukraine. She has been there standing up for the rights of the oppressed. She has been there standing up for free speech and democracy from the earliest days through the present. She has earned international acclaim for her work. Earlier this year, she received the International Woman of Courage Award and the Atlantic Council's Distinguished Humanitarian Leadership Award. Last year, Forbes magazine recognized her as one of the world's 10 most influential women. So, ladies and gentlemen, please let's give a welcome to Ruslana.
Thank you. Thank you much. Thank you so much.
Where is translator?
In the...
Okay. Okay.
It's very difficult to say everything for this very, very important period of time. Not just I speak not just about Ukraine, but about all countries around the world. It's very difficult to explain if you can see the truth. You have to use your voice. You have to use your name. It doesn't matter how big it is propaganda. And I'm strong enough. And I am voice against Putin's propaganda. My speech about the most dangerous weapons in the world, Putin's propaganda.
Я хочу говорити зараз українською мовою.
I would like to speak now in Ukrainian, and the reason, important reason for that is that in order to be heard in Ukraine as well. Because I felt how important or how dangerous is Putin's propaganda in my country. And I want to speak Ukrainian so that Putin will have no chance to change my words. And this is why I will be speaking my native language today. What are my conclusions of the recent event and the analysis of Putin's propaganda? Everything that is hard to believe, it's true. And I ask you to learn to identify Putin's propaganda, because it is everywhere. It is everywhere in the world. And the most important message, my message today is my independent position. We need to preserve peace. Perhaps I'm the first singer who have released or helped in liberation of 40 military. And not only I was taking risk at Maidan, while under the bullets, I went to Donetsk 3 times. And I released 40 of Ukrainian military who were captured by Russians or rebels. You see the person who started and held a peacekeeper's mission in Ukraine. After my trip to Donetsk, I returned to Kyiv and I said, stop fire, cease fire. And we tried to do the humanitarian corridor of help. And we brought humanitarian aid, medical supplies and food to Donetsk. Today my peacekeeper's mission is to cease Putin's fire.
Після моєї поїздки в Донецьк, я хочу вам сказати, Київ і Донецьк не хочуть воювати.
After my trip to Donetsk, I would like to say that Kyiv and Donetsk do not want to be it, do not want to fight. This is why we insist that Russian army, up to the single soldier, should leave Ukrainian territory. And now we need help and assistance for the destroyed regions. We started the communication and dialogue. We started trusting each other. And we want to be together. All territories of Ukraine. I'm certain that things that I'm saying now are not taken favorably but by only one person.
Why Putin wants to kill us? Because we choose the democracy on the Maidan. Because we say to him, no.
I came today to US because this is a democratic country and I can say everything freely. And I will not be afraid, I'm not afraid that my words will be twisted by Putin. I came here to gather all independent people of the world, independent of Putin, who are capable to give him a real resistance. People who are independent of Putin, who are capable to stop him. Because on my own example and my own experience, I know now that only independent people can stop Putin. How does Putin's propaganda work? A small masterclass for you from a person who became a victim to Putin's propaganda. Putin was creating and imposing on you the image of Ukraine as a country of chaos. But he is a person who created chaos in Ukraine. Putin's propaganda is creating images of enemies inside the Ukraine. During Maidan, he created the image of fascism. And he used this image of fascism to scare Donetsk. And we are certain that subversive groups of Russia were providing those images for Russia today from Eastern Ukraine. Images of terrorists and separatists and mercenaries in Donetsk. Putin did everything to make us believe that when we come to east of Ukraine, there will be enemy. The result of this Putin's propaganda is more than 220,000 of refugees. It's a destroyed region now. And this is a war of Putin. What is his next plan today? Because you heard that he is moving the Russian army away from the border. Never trust Putin. He needs this freeze on conflict to change and modify his plan. He may be taking away those troops.
Модерує путінська пропаганда у всьому світі і в Україні в першу чергу.
What is propaganda primarily moderating today in the world?
Це не
everybody. Коли ми перестаємо один одному довіряти.
When we stop trusting each other.
Коли ми навіть самі собі довіряємо.
And when we even do not trust ourselves.
Тому я ще раз вертаюсь до своїх тез. Все, що важко повірити, це є правда.
And this is why I return to my thesis that everything that is hard to believe is truth.
І наступна, я так думаю, хвиля путінської пропаганди буде – це депресія.
And
я колись говорила тут, в Вашингтоні, в квітні місяці, що ми рано чи пізно побачимо обличчя Третьої світової війни.
I was saying earlier here in Washington in April that sooner or later we will see the face of Putin's war.
Не допомагайте путінській пропаганді говорити, що це проблеми України.
Please do not help Putin's propaganda to say that this is problem of Ukraine.
Це неправда.
This is not true.
Це є проблема всього світу.
This is a problem of the whole world.
Якщо ракети російські збивають міжнародні літаки, навіть якщо це в українському небі, це і міжнародна трагедія.
If Russian rockets take down international airplanes, even if this happens in Ukraine and over Ukrainian territory, this is an international problem.
Я звертаюсь до вас в Америці як до вільно думаючих людей.
I appeal to you here in US as to freely thinking people.
Не вірте чуткам.
Do not believe gossips.
Перевіряйте інформацію.
Check information.
Звідки, яке джерело?
Check sources.
Можливо, це лобі Путіна.
Perhaps the source was from Putin.
Звідки ми знаємо, який журналіст робив ці новини?
How do we know which journalist made those news?
Можливо, ми вже говоримо зараз, як потрібно Путіну.
Perhaps we are already speaking in the way that Putin wants us to speak.
Можливо, ми вже думаємо, як потрібно Путіну.
Perhaps we are already thinking in the way Putin wants us to think.
Можливо, ми вже робимо так, як потрібно Путіну.
And perhaps we are already acting in the way Putin wants us to act.
От в цьому моя миротворча місія. Стоп вогонь.
My peacekeeper's mission. Stop fire, cease fire.
Стоп вогонь Путіна.
Cease fire of Putin.
Бо це його вогонь.
Because this is his fire.
Це не вогонь України.
This isn't fire of Ukraine.
Моя країна не хоче воювати.
My country doesn't want war.
І я не хочу, щоб Путін нав'язував моїй країні, що ми хочемо воювати. Це неправда.
And I don't want Putin to impose on Ukraine this notion that Ukraine wants war.
Ми хочемо зберегти Україну.
We want to preserve Ukraine.
Ми захищаємо Україну.
We preserve Ukraine and defend Ukraine.
І це єдине, що нам потрібно.
And that is the only thing that we need.
Зараз буде дуже важливий меседж.
And now will be a very important message.
Я закликаю Америку і Європу допомогти створити період так званого миру, не так званого, а період миру, і ще раз повторюю, я закликаю Америку і Європу допомогти створити період миру і спокою в Україні.
I appeal to US and Europe to help in creating a period of peace in Ukraine.
Я закликаю Америку і Європу зробити Україну сильною.
I appeal to US and Europe to help making Ukraine strong.
Сильна Україна, саме сильна Україна зробить слабим диктатора і його імперію.
If Ukraine or when Ukraine will be strong, this will make the dictator weaker.
Ми повинні стати незалежно економічно. Незалежними економічно.
Independent economically.
Ми маємо стати незалежними енергетично.
We must become independent in energy.
Ми повинні могти себе захистити, свої кордони і свої території.
We must be able to defend our borders and territories.
Це мій найголовніший меседж.
And this is my key message.
Важливіше за це я своїй країні сьогодні нічого не можу сказати. Це найбільше.
I cannot say anything more important for my country at this point.
Єдине, що я вам хочу сказати, Путін не такий вже і страшний, який себе робить.
The only one more thing I would like to say is that Putin is not as scary as he may appear.
По факту, із власного досвіду, після того, як я поїхала в Донецьк і побачила правду, я скажу, чого він боїться.
After I came to Donetsk and saw the truth, I can say what is Putin afraid of.
Він боїться прозріння.
He is afraid of people seeing the truth.
Він боїться, коли люди одного разу побачать правду.
He is afraid that one day people will see the truth.
І він боїться, що люди будуть об'єднуватися, зустрічатися і з'ясовувати, що це була брехня Путіна.
And he is afraid that one day people will be meeting and they will see that all of this were the lies of Putin.
Мир і спокій Україні. Peace and tranquility for Ukraine and around the world. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Your leadership, your bravery, your example, I think are really admired by so many in the room and so many around the world. I wondered if we could just have a conversation for a few minutes. I want to recognize Carl Gershman and Ambassador Morsik. Mm-hmm. And maybe at some point they would like to share some observations. You good?
Yeah, absolutely.
We're really interested in the strength of civil society in Ukraine. I think you're absolutely right that not only Mr. Putin, but I think all sorts of dictators around the world are frightened by the kind of people power that we saw that you were a part of. Mm-hmm. What's going on with civil society in Ukraine today? And I ask that in part because I think there's so much focus. Is it not working?
I understand.
Okay.
It's for sure.
There's so much focus on the East, and we understand that, Mr. Putin. But the rest of Ukraine is so important to have a conversation about. And what's the mood? What's the feeling? And how hopeful are your colleagues in civil society?
Можеш перекладати далі?
Так,
я можу тут говорити, щоб вона перекладала, окей? Why I speak Ukrainian? To inform my country, to kill Putin's propaganda, and sometimes I need to explain you more than my English, sorry. Ти готова?
Хвилиночку.
Зараз. Something wrong with the equipment. You just wait for to prepare it. Окей. Що насправді я вважаю зараз потрібно Україні? Який мирний план потрібен Україні зараз?
What is a peace plan that I believe is important for Ukraine now?
І це дуже важливо, тому що президент України розпочав, як тільки став президентом, він розпочав мирний план.
And this is very important because when the new president or when we had our when Poroshenko became a president, he started this peace plan.
Нам потрібна політична стабільність в Україні.
We need political stability in Ukraine.
Нам потрібна єдність всіх демократичних сил.
We need a unity of all democratic forces in Ukraine.
Нам потрібно більшість для того, щоб розвивати демократичні процеси і реформи.
And we need to have majority of people in order to join and unite in order to support
Нам дуже важливі вибори в Україні зараз.
And
дуже важливі вибори в Україні зараз.
And this is why elections in Ukraine are very important now.
І я прошу вас допомогти зробити все, щоб Путін їх не зірвав.
And I am asking you, appealing to you, to make everything in order to prevent Putin to obstructing those elections.
Я знаю, якщо я не скажу те, що я вам маю розказати, мене чоловік назад не пустить додому.
And I know that if I will not tell you what I'm going to tell you now, my husband will not let me back home.
Тому що мій чоловік зараз повністю допомагає, ми разом розробляємо так звану інформаційну кампанію енергетичної незалежності України.
Because both me and my husband at the moment are
actively involved in the information campaign of energy independence of Ukraine.
Так, ми використовуємо всі свої ресурси, всі свої зв'язки, всі свої можливості для того, щоб Україна була енергетично незалежна.
And we are using all our networking, all our resources, all our connections in order to help Ukraine become energy independent.
І я закликаю Європу до цього. And I'm бути енергетично незалежною.
Europe to this.
I ask Europe to be energy independent. And I also ask America, let's help us to be energy independent. It's very important for us. Я знаю, що розпочиналися вже слухання в американському конгресі, щоб допомогти демонополізувати регіон енергетично.
I know that hearings have already started in American Congress to help demonopolize the sector and region.
Демонополізувати енергетичний регіон.
To demonopolize.
Енергетику в регіоні. Ну, переклади, щоб...
Якому регіоні?
Forget about it. Everybody understand. My body language. Я чула тут сама особисто, я була на цих слуханнях з Робертом МакКоннеллом і Ukraine US Foundation, і тут Маркіян Білинський є присутній, на слуханнях в Конгресі, коли містер Ройс, я чула, проводив ці слухання за можливість розглядання, що Америка може розглядати допомогу бути енергетично незалежним в цьому нашому регіону.
I was at the hearings in Congress with Robert McConnell and at some other meetings where it was discussed that US possibly may be helping the region Ukraine, the region of Ukraine or the Ukraine as a region of the world to become energy independent.
Це слухання були в Конгресі. Містер Ройс якраз робив ці слухання.
This was a hearing in Congress, in US Congress.
Я би дуже хотіла, щоб в нас було більше мистецьких проєктів для обміну, щоб ви розуміли більше ментальність українців.
And I would also like to have more art projects and the art cultural exchange programs.
Тому що нам дуже необхідно, щоб ви від нас розуміли, хто ми є, а не від Путіна.
Because this would help and it is very important for us that you would understand us and who we are.
And а це можливо через мистецькі проекти.
And you will be in this way you will be able to understand us and do not listen to Putin.
Обов'язково нам потрібна економічна підтримка.
Economic support is necessary.
Нам потрібно інвестиції. Нам потрібно інвестиції в реформи. Всі ці акценти, будь ласка, залишайте at the highest level.
We need investments in reforms. And please keep those as your priority.
Як тільки ми з вами виводимо головну мету, Путін пропагандою обов'язково її повинен перебити, щоб ми забули про неї.
As soon as we identify our key goals, Putin immediately starts using his propaganda to target them and все, to distract our attention from them.
Все, що люди хочуть, це спокійного життя, що в Києві, що в Донецьку, що у Львові.
All people want either in Kyiv or Donetsk or Lviv in Ukraine is that they want peaceful, calm life.
You have, I think, provided a very provocative idea for those of us in this room. There are a lot of people here who have been working on democracy and human rights issues around the world for a long time. There's some of us who've been thinking that energy independence has a very interesting relationship with enhanced work on democracy and human rights around the world. But we haven't really had a detailed conversation with our colleagues who work in the energy sector or who are working in the green sector, who might be actually more interested in this. I think your idea of a campaign is a really important one. To the degree that you meet colleagues in Europe and elsewhere in the United States that are interested in this, you should get their names and you know sort of start making your movement not only in Euromaidan but elsewhere and share the names with us. I think there's a lot of work to be done in this. It hasn't been a natural coalition, but it's a very intriguing idea.
I want to add something. Я би хотіла зараз фокусувати вашу увагу на дуже важливому факті.
I would like to focus your attention on a very important fact.
Вчора були оприлюднені факти причасності російських військ до збитого малайзійського літака.
Yesterday were made public facts that proven the connection or involvement of Russian armed forces to the airplane
Malaysia.
Malaysian airplane being taken
MH-17.
Down.
MH-17, okay. Це не є, це міжнародна вже проблема і трагедія.
This is an international problem and international tragedy.
Ці факти, якщо є зафіксовані, в тому числі і американською технікою, ми хочемо мати всі докази, що це зробили російські військові. Тому що сьогодні був меседж і заява міністра оборони Росії з звинуваченням, що це зробила Україна, що є брехня.
If those facts are on record, and if there are records of those facts taken by American technology, we would like to have access to them, because there already has been made statements that this is a lie. This is a lie that Russian armed forces were involved in any way with this accident.
Візьми ближче мікрофон і трошки веселіше, бо зараз буде засну. Ми повинні взяти всі факти, які вказують на причетність російських військ до збитого малайзійського літака, і Україна разом з Голландією, ми повинні розпочати процес в Гаазькому суді слідства.
Ukraine, we need to have all those facts about involvement of Russian armed forces to the airplane crash, Malaysian airplane crash, and together with
Ukraine,
Netherlands,
together with Holland,
start the investigation and made an appeal to the Gaag court.
Нам є що принести в Гаагський суд.
We have enough evidence to present to the court in Gaag.
Тому що стільки, скільки людей вбив Путін за цей час, його місце в Гаагському суді.
Because Putin by now killed so many people or was involved in killings of so many people that he belongs to the court in Gaag.
Йому не корону на голову треба вдягати, а сідати на скам'ю на підсудимим.
He needs not to wear the crown, but to become a convict.
Я знайшла інформацію, що Путін хоче себе коронувати, цар.
I found information that Putin wants to become a tsar or an emperor and have a crown.
Мені страшно за Росію.
And I'm fearing for Russia.
Мене лякає такий цар для Росії.
And I'm fearing for Russia to have such a tsar.
Треба зробити все для того, щоб сама Росія дізналася правду.
We must do everything for Russia to learn the truth, especially Russia.
Це неможливо. Путінська пропаганда просто вб'є саму Росію.
Because Putin's propaganda will kill Russia.
Там не залишиться жодної вільно думаючої людини скоро.
Soon there will be no more free-thinking people in Russia.
Але я дуже сподіваюся, що всередині самої Росії такі є супротив.
But I hope very much that inside Russia there still is some resistance to Putin.
Тому що ми просто не знаємо. Нас відділили від Росії, відрізали повністю.
Because right now we don't
з Росією настільки, що ми не знаємо, що робиться в самій Росії.
There is too much division with Russia right now, and we do not know what is going on inside Russia.
I totally agree. I had the privilege of doing a lot of survey work in Russia previously, over a dozen surveys. I think that work is impossible today. I do think survey work in Ukraine is important, and understanding how Ukrainians are thinking about a variety of issues so that we really have a very good feel. We have a lot of friends who are leaving Russia because they feel that there's no future for them there, and it's about as sad an indictment I can think of when we think of where we all were 20, 25 years ago. I wonder if Carl or Ambassador Motsyuk, you'd like to offer any words or question?
I don't need a mic, I can speak just normally. Okay.
I think you may need a mic for the translator.
Okay.
Hi. I'm Carl Gershman, and I'm the president of the National Endowment for Democracy. Nadja Duke is with us today, who has helped oversee our programs in Ukraine since before 1991, well before 1991. In any event, you have a lot of friends. I want you to know that. And as I told you last night at the IRI dinner, I would like to see my country do much, much more to help your struggle. I believe your struggle is absolutely essential to American security and to the future of freedom and democracy in the world. It's your struggle, but it also has a much, much larger significance, and I believe our country should be doing much more to help you. The question I want to ask follows up on something that Sarah just said, which is Ukrainian attitudes. One of the main points of Putin's propaganda is that Ukraine is a divided country, that not everybody feels like they're Ukrainian, especially in the East, where he says they feel less Ukrainian than they feel Russian. Could you speak to us a little bit about the Ukrainian people and whether a strong sense of Ukrainian national identity is emerging as a result of this struggle for independence and democracy?
Thank you for this question. I like this microphone more. Can you hear me? Because it's louder. It's louder.
She's going to break into song.
I will.
Does she need to take off the other microphone? I see our tech person in dismay. She's OK? OK, good.
Ти чуєш мене, так?
Так.
Не сумнівайтесь ні секунди, що Україна демократична.
Please do not hesitate even for a moment that Ukraine is a democratic state.
Я вам більше скажу. Після поїздки в Донецьку, мені здається, що прозрів і сам Донецьк.
I will tell you even more. After my trip to Donetsk, I think, I believe that even in Donetsk people are understanding this.
Ну, тому що я не подібна ніяк на фашистку.
Because I do not look like a fascist.
І це треба говорити простим людям. Вони просто повинні мати від нас інформацію. Все.
And we must say this to everybody, to common people, and they should be able to have this information from us. And that's all that is needed.
Тобто, дякуючи путінській пропаганді, демократія стає сильнішою в Україні.
And thanks to Putin's propaganda, democracy becomes stronger in Ukraine.
І нам треба навчитися використовувати путінську пропаганду. І я знаю як.
And we need to learn how to use Putin's propaganda to our own benefit, and I know how to do it.
Тому що його брехня викликає такий супротив, що хочеться правду говорити в два рази більше і в два рази голосніше.
Because his lies create such a resistance that there is a will to say truth twice louder and twice stronger than his propaganda.
Він просто своєю брехнею піднімає зараз півсвіту, тому що люди ніколи не погодяться з брехнею, ніколи.
And he right now is helping half the world to raise because people will never agree with lies.
Але мені от, наприклад, не зрозуміло, як можна позбавити саму Україну від впливу іноді російських мас-медіа.
But at the moment I do not quite understand how to free Ukraine from the influence of Russian mass media.
Мені не зрозуміло, як можна саму Україну позбавити від такої кількості людей, які знаходяться в Україні і роблять диверсії на всіх рівнях.
I do not know how to solve the issue of so many people in Ukraine who are making subversions on so many different levels.
Інформаційний саботаж.
Information саботаж.
Політичний саботаж.
Political саботаж.
Економічний саботаж.
And economic саботаж.
На всіх рівнях саботаж.
On all levels there is a саботаж.
Тому треба Україну зробити сильнішою.
This is why we need to make Ukraine stronger.
І ми залишилися тим самим Майданом. От він перед вами сидить.
And we remain the same Майдан, and you see Майдан in front of you. I'm sitting here.
І якщо вам Путін щось буде говорити про нас,
and if Putin will be telling you something about us,
то не слухайте ні Russia Today, ні інші джерела, а прийдіть в Україну і послухайте нас.
And do not then if Putin will be saying something about us, do not listen to Russia Today or any other of his sources. Just come to Ukraine and listen to us.
Беріть адвайзерів, приїжджайте в Україну, навчайте нас програмам.
Take advisors, come to Ukraine, start programs in Ukraine.
Ну і дайте незалежним голосам, таким як я, більше говорити в демократичних країнах, таких як Америка.
And please allow to independent voices like myself to speak up more in Absolutely. Independent free countries.
There's no question that having more people go to Ukraine, travel around Ukraine, I think is incredibly important to counter the images that we're seeing. I've written that I think colleagues should not be going on Russia Today. I think it really feeds into a propaganda machine. I wonder if the ambassador would like to say a word?
Well, just...
Okay, thank you very much. First of all, I would like to express my deep gratitude to organizers of this event and to invite in Ruslana. Ruslana is really a phenomenon
really?
In Ukraine. I can say that Maidan without her would be maybe much more different Maidan. Hmm. Not that Maidan that we have, the revolution of dignity. And now she continues her activity to help Ukraine, to help Ukraine go through this very difficult period. And as ambassador of Ukraine, and she is ambassador at large, she mm-hmm. represents Ukraine not only in the United States, but throughout the world. So as ambassador of Ukraine, I just would like to wish her to be today, tomorrow, and for the future, such active as she is, with a big heart, with a feeling about her own country and about future of Ukraine. So.
You know, it's Thank very you. Important that activists like you...
Slava Ukraine.
Slava Ukraine. It's very important that activists like you take care of yourself. Right, that you don't get so exhausted. And I know you were giving back energy all the time to people in Maidan Square, but I think you must take care of yourself. You have to eat healthy.
Uh-huh.
And get sleep.
So eat sometime.
Eat sometime.
And sleep sometimes.
Yes,
it helps.
Yes. But I mean, clearly the power of your songs, the power of your voice, both spoken but singing, was extremely important. And it's something that played a role in our civil rights movement. It's not something that we focus on a lot, but my last name is Mendelssohn, so you know, I think music is extremely powerful. My mother was a singer. It's something that we don't recognize enough oftentimes, so I appreciate your comment about the focus on culture and art. I wonder if you wanted to respond.
I think you know the most important melody in the world, which is from Ukraine. This melody from Ukraine.
So yes. We got her to sing. There you go.
Пропаганда показує, що Україна роз'єднана. Так от, наскільки
Моя поїздка в Донецьк показала вам, що нас роз'єднує тільки Путін і більше нічого.
My trip to Donetsk shown to you that Eastern and Western Ukraine are separated only by Putin and nothing else.
Я знаю, у нас стільки багато інформації, ви просто не повірите.
I have so much information that it's hard to comprehend how much information I have.
Тому що, ще раз повторюю, все, в що важко повірити, це правда.
And I would like to repeat once more that everything that is hard to believe is truth.
Я вам хочу сказати, що в моєму серці є великий біль сьогодні.
My heart is filled with pain today.
Тому що російські медіа після моєї поїздки в Донецьк сказали, що Руслана була в Донецьку і не побачила російської агресії. Це брехня.
Russian media, my heart is filled with pain because Russian media after my trip to Donetsk have told people that Ruslana went to Donetsk and didn't see any of Russian aggression there.
Це брехня, тому що російська пропаганда, я її не побачила в Донецьку. Але російська агресія, перепрошую, вона є всюди по Україні.
And this is a lie, because although I didn't see Russian aggression in Donetsk during my trip there, there is Russian aggression everywhere in Ukraine today.
Вони сидять, їх армія сидить по кущах.
Their army is hiding in the bushes.
Вони перемасковуються завжди, переодягаються.
They're always hiding and disguising themselves.
То вони зелені чоловічки.
Sometimes they are green men.
То вони переодягаються в якихось, не знаю, інших, якісь герої.
Sometimes they are disguised as heroes or some sort of other men.
Ми надивилися цей спектакль Путіна, це кроваве шоу Путіна, ми вже ситі по горло.
We are fed up with this bloody performance prepared by Putin.
Скажи, що ми вже ситі по горло тим шоу. А тому я сьогодні, чому біль в серці? Тому що Путін спробував збрехати про голос Майдану, про Руслану в самій Україні.
And my heart is in pain because Putin tried to lie about the voice of Maidan, about Ruslana.
Але Путін нерозумний чоловік.
But he is not a wise man.
Він зробив мене цим ще сильнішою.
He made me stronger by this lie.
Тому що завжди сила там, де правда.
Because the strength is always where the truth lies.
Треба просто її шукати, знаходити, бачити і говорити.
We just need to seek it, find it, see it and speak about it.
Ну нікому в голову не прийшло, що після такої кількості вогню Руслана не побоїться поїхати сама в Донецьк.
No one could have guessed that after such amount of conflict, armed conflict, Ruslana would not be afraid to go to Donetsk.
Мене ніхто не кликав, ніхто нічого ніяк не підводив. Я сама захотіла поїхати допомогти полоненим.
No one invited me there. This was my own decision and I was compelled to go there and help the captured Ukrainian military and see everything for myself.
We're coming to the end of our time. There are several things that I think we need to take away from this and to work on. Number one, this issue of energy independence, and having that conversation includes some of us who work on the democracy and human rights piece. Certainly this issue of media and mass media, I hear your message very loud and clear, and I've heard it from many other colleagues, and I've seen it myself. When I was in Dnipropetrovsk watching Ukrainian television, then watching Russian television, and it was like a twilight zone. We have an imperative to go to Ukraine, to have more people going to Ukraine and going and coming back and talking about what we're seeing. Certainly attitudes of Ukrainians, the cultural piece. And we need to keep talking about what else is going on in Ukraine, not just the violence, but the bravery and the legacy of Euromaidan. Yes.
So, we are patriots.
Well, we're pulling for you, and we're oh, and of course there's the very important additional aspect of what not only the United States but European partners can be doing together with Ukrainians. So please join me in thanking Ruslana.
No, it's not the end.
We don't.
Can I add something? The last one. How many people? Can you show me how many people support Ukraine? You're my brother and sister. Welcome to Ukraine. Щойно ви вбили пропаганду Путіна. You kill the Putin's propaganda right now.
We're out of time, so I want to thank you for joining us. I know you've got
I will join you, a
busy schedule, and you can offline. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.